Hey everybody, it's Mike Aloia. Welcome to the Mr. Entertainer Show. This is a special edition, and it's going to be basically a reflection of what we just did last weekend over at the First Unity Spiritual Campus in St. Petersburg, Florida. I was just honored, I'm so honored and humbled that I am a recipient of the People of Distinction Awards with Al Cole from CBS Radio. And I tell you, I've been on a lot of stages my whole life and been on stage probably since I was 9 years old. And that was the most surreal, important stage I've ever been on in my life. And to have my ministry family from Hands and Feet there to support me, as well as Frankie Holbrook from Shine His Light Ministry, having Rich Norton and Lee Norton and James and Amy Gandy and Jim Wilson, and having my dad there with my daughter and my buddy Ed Carnivale. Man, it was just an unbelievable experience for me. And I tell you, I am nothing without Jesus Christ, okay? The only reason that I was put in that position and put on that stage with all these prestigious people from around the world is because that's where God has positioned me in this network, in this ministry. And I humble myself. I like to show you a lot of highlights from the award ceremony on this episode of Mr. Entertainer. So I hope you enjoy it as much as I enjoyed being there on stage. And God bless everybody. We'll talk to you soon. Rock and roll.
In his spiritual way. Mike! Yeah. Welcome to People of Distinction.
Thank you, Al. God bless you, brother. I'd like my daughter to bring that bag up here because I got something for Al. Allison, bring that bag up here, honey.
Okay.
I want to say thank God for me being here today. He is the only reason I'm here. For my Lord Jesus Christ. There's a lot of people out there that are lost, looking for the light, looking for love and compassion. It's my daughter Allison. Luke 19:10, the Son of Man came to seek and save the lost. The Lord put in my heart to build sanctuaries in all these cities where there's prostitution, heroin addicts, people dying, or God's children dying in the neighborhoods on the street in the middle of the night. He put it in my heart to build a sanctuary in every city across this nation. And through the ministries that'll make it happen, like Hands and Feet Foundation with Mr. James and Amy Gandy right there. Epidemic on 103rd Street in Jacksonville, Florida. They're feeding the homeless daily, giving them clothes. They're getting our veterans into housing that are homeless. They're getting addicts into rehab and into detox. And they're working with our at-risk youth and helping change lives. I'd like to thank Richard Norton and Lee, Mr. Jim Wilson, James and Amy Gandy for Hands and Feet Foundation. They're making a difference, and there needs to be a Hands and Feet everywhere to where people can go, a sanctuary. 24/7 is what God has put in my heart, to where you're not going to die out there on the street in the middle of the night thinking that nobody cares. So American Hearts Radio, that's our mission. We're on a mission from God, is to bring the hearts of the world together and to make a difference in this world and every community. Just like my friend Frankie Holbert from Shine His Light Ministry, she flew in from Atlanta, Georgia. She goes into the front lines and ministers to all these homeless people that are out there. She just got back from Los Angeles and ministered to the people at Skid Row. It's an amazing woman right there. I'd like to give a big round of applause for this great woman. And I'd like to thank David Lebecki from Canada, because God works through people. And that's the reason I'm here, is because God brought people together. We are assembled here today in the name of Jesus. And I'd like to give Mr. Cole these paintings from Meg Scott. Okay, Meg Scott is one of our web television personalities in Texas and makes paintings and donates them everywhere to help put smiles on people's faces. And we also honor our military and veteran communities nationwide. We work with our motorcycle communities. And I also want to give thanks to Donnie and Johnny Van Zandt of Leonard Skinner, the 38 Special. They have taken care of me most of my life and they endorse our network. Johnny Van Zandt, he's my brother in Christ. And his daughter, Lindsay, was a humanitarian. And she did a lot with battered women and rescued animals. But her life was cut short at 35 years old. She just died of leukemia. But her name will go on forever because we're going to make sure of her that she'll be recognized. So this painting here, I gave Al a bracelet with Lindsay's name on it. This is a painting from Meg Scott from our motorcycle community signed by Donnie and Johnny Van Zandt. That's for you, Mr. Al. Patriot. Along the shores to show freedom. That's our gift to you, Mr. Cole. And I humble myself, and I thank you for having us out here tonight and recognizing me and American Arts Radio Entertainment Network. This is God bringing people together to make things happen. In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
stage, up and at him right now. Get that music going.
He now was corporate senior vice president. He He had a wonderful wife and two beautiful children he shared with me. And he thanked me again. And I knew that sharing, that's why Bob and I do what we do, in helping other people. So that, I'll thank you for coming up.
What I just talked about. This evening we heard a number of wonderful stories, stories about what people deliberately set out to do. Great success and great feeling and great spirit. I'd like to share a story that really happened by accident. One of the things that I do is I write a newspaper column. I've been doing that for about 10 years now. And one evening, Eileen and I were leaving a cocktail party. And a lady there, a lady whom we knew, and had known for quite some time, she pulled us aside and she said to me, "I have to tell you something." It was an untypical way for address me. And I said, "Okay, how come?" She said, "I need to tell you that you changed my life." Now that's scary when somebody says that to you, because I was not aware of anything in particular I had done, but whatever it was important to her. So I said, "Well, tell me about that." And she said, "For a long time, I was in a very, very bad relationship. Horrible, and I didn't know how to get out of it. And I was getting worse and worse and worse. And one day, my mother gave me a piece of paper. Now it happened to be a piece of newspaper paper. And on it was one of my columns. And in that column, I had made a very strong pitch with a simple recognition, simple to say, difficult to do. Regardless of how complicated an issue is, regardless of the details involved in it, sooner or later, every complicated issue can be resolved and must be resolved to a very simple yes or no.